Hello, I'm Sergeant Efrain Cornejo. As part of the Milwaukee Police Department's continuous commitment to be transparent with our community, we created community briefings to provide information to the public regarding officer-involved critical incidents. Community briefings are intended to provide relevant information, which may include video footage, audio recordings, photographs, and other evidence. It is our priority to release this information and inform our community as soon as possible, unless releasing the information will compromise the integrity of the investigation. When watching this video, keep in mind that this may still be an ongoing investigation. For privacy purposes, we have concealed audio and images of community members captured in this video. The video you are about to see may contain officers using force, explicit language, and disturbing images. Viewer discretion is strongly advised.
Hello, I am Inspector Shannon M. Seimer-Tabaska with the Milwaukee Police Department. In this community briefing, I'm going to share with you information regarding circumstances surrounding the death of a citizen while in police custody within Police District Number 5 on the city's north side on the evening of February 23rd, 2022. This occurred within the temporary holding cell at the district station. The following is a picture of the cell the subject was in when he became despondent. Police contact with the subject was initiated during a traffic stop in the early morning hours of February 23rd, 2022, in the 2000 block of West Capitol Drive. Officers conducted the stop for a moving traffic violation. An adult male driver and an adult female passenger who was released from the scene occupied the vehicle. The driver was taken into custody for a Milwaukee County Sheriff's Department warrant, and a thorough search incident to arrest resulted in the recovery of narcotics from the driver. The subject was cooperative and he was detained without incident or force. The following is the arresting officer's body-worn camera video of the initial traffic stop where the subject had first contact with officers and was taken into custody.
Hello, sir.
Hey, how you doing, sir?
I'm Officer Maritato with the Milwaukee Police Department. The reason I'm stopping you tonight is for failure to signal the lane change back there.
Oh,
all right. What's going on with that? I also saw you put your hazards on. Is everything okay?
I don't think I put my hazards on.
Oh, okay.
She probably was trying to grab my phone and probably hit the button.
Okay.
Yeah, that's all.
Get your ID on you, boss?
I don't. I can show you, like,
some. I can just get your name and everything real quick. Hold on.
I can show you identification.
Let me just get your name. Hold on 1 second.
He was picking me up from the inside. He's playing me at
27th and Atkinson?
Yeah.
Okay, hold on, let me just get this notebook out. Just tell me your last name, it'll be easier, sir.
Yes, sir.
Common? Common, yes. Common spelling?
Yep, yep.
First. And middle initial. Date of birth. Where you live at? Where you live at, boss?
I live on.
Phone number. All right. And do you have insurance on the vehicle? Is the vehicle list to you?
Yeah, just got it.
Just got it?
Please hello. Bring us 7 North or Unit A. We have a female caller stating she believes someone's trying to get
all right.
Into our home. Can I take
my teacup?
You say something, miss?
I was asking if I could take my
teacup. Oh, yeah, absolutely. All right. Just stand by. We'll be right back with you in a minute, okay, boss?
Okay, sir.
46. What's the step out of the car?
10-4.
Bring it to my bed.
Can I grab my phone?
Yeah, we'll grab it. We're just going to go back to the car.
Got it.
Just go over and
get some. Is there anything wrong with
you? You got a warrant.
Following the arrest, the subject was transported to District 5 for further processing. After removing the subject from the police vehicle, officers conducted another search incident to arrest, and as the officer reached into subject's left pants pocket, the subject lunged forward towards the rear seat of the squad where he was seated and attempted to ingest a white rock-like substance believed to be narcotics. In this video, you will see the subject lunge forward and hear the subject state, "I ate him. I ate the little smoke I had."
Come on, boss.
Can I eat? Can I eat the little smoke in my pocket?
Yeah, hold on. What pocket?
Yeah, pocket. Got it. Yeah.
Which one?
This one. Over here.
He's trying to eat it.
I'm sorry.
Alright, so there's one rock. Where's the other one?
I have no more. I ate them.
You ate them?
I ate the little smoke I had.
Officers continued their search of the subject and a large quantity of U.S. currency and multiple packaged illegal substances, marijuana, methamphetamine, and cocaine, were removed from the subject's person.
Crack.
We gotta eat. But honestly, I only had one piece. She shared with me.
She what?
She shared with me. My auntie, I got out of the car.
It's not your auntie.
It is.
You guys are like the same age. How can that be your aunt?
You know how old she is? She's 41.
How old are you?
I'm only 20.
In the money?
No, I just came from gambling with my cousin and that's when my mom called me and I think she'd get hurt.
During the booking process, the subject was seated and handcuffed in the temporary booking room when he reached into his buttocks area and removed a packaged white substance believed to be narcotics that he placed into his mouth and began chewing. The subject removed an additional packaged white substance from his buttocks area and dropped the package on the floor. Subject attempted to retrieve the package with his left foot, however, was unsuccessful and concealed it with the garbage can located in the room. Thank you. A routine medical questionnaire was administered to the subject, in which he appeared to be alert, following instructions, and completed the booking process without incident. The subject indicated he had ingested one rock and one ecstasy pill, and the booking officer advised the subject he should go to the hospital. However, the subject refused medical. The booking officer further asked the subject if he had any physical injuries, and the subject responded that his wrist had a mark from the handcuff.
I know you're there. I got to do it too. So if you want to say, I'll just take a moment here. How are you feeling?
I'm fine. All right.
Huh? Feeling intoxicated though? Inebriated? A little high?
Yeah.
Okay. You not dizzy or anything?
No, I'm not dizzy.
Heart rate's okay?
Should be. I have three different
things. What's the other? Is he in the crack?
Yeah.
I actually see him well.
In
the week, no? One rack and then one ecstasy pill. If he had more, I mean, be honest, you're not going to be in trouble for that. I just need to know why you're here with us. Because
yeah.
I really need to go to the hospital just to check out your vitals and all that, just to make sure that you're okay. I mean, being high is one thing, I don't care, but. But it's face alarming. I know you don't want to, but, I mean, like, how many ecstasy pills do you have? I mean, did you sell some in your mouth and the officer stop you, or?
One and a half ecstasy pills, and the sweet. Yeah,
and that was an hour before they stopped you.
Nothing since then.
This is an example of the form the subject signed. The subject was then placed in cell block number 5 to await transport to the Milwaukee County Criminal Justice Facility. The following is a video from the holding cell area. You will see the subject being placed in cell block 5. During a cell block check, the booker noticed that the subject was not breathing. He entered the cell to check the welfare of the subject and then summoned assistance from other officers to remove subject from the cell block. The officers immediately activated emergency medical service, EMS, by performing cardiopulmonary resuscitation, CPR, to the subject. Medical attention was summoned and medical personnel attended to the subject where life-saving measures were attempted. The subject was ultimately pronounced deceased by medical personnel. The cause of death at this time is unknown and under investigation. This investigation is ongoing and being led by the Milwaukee Area Investigative Team MATE with the Waukesha Police Department as the lead agency. The officers involved in this incident were placed on full suspension, and at the conclusion of Waukesha Police Department's investigation, they will present this case to the Milwaukee County District Attorney's Office for a review.